I first met the composer of the music from Men of La Mancha, Mitch Lee, after I received a phone call from his assistant saying that the composer wanted to have an in-person meeting with me. So we set up a meeting and he came over to my New York apartment. When I opened the door, I saw this very simpatico man sporting a full beard, and he had an unlit cigar in his hand, and he was wearing a velveteen leisure suit. So he came in, and with him was a very sweet man by the name of Neil Warner. Neil Warner, he was the conductor and the musical director of the Broadway musical of Men of La Mancha. And so I was very intrigued. What did he want from me? That he wanted this meeting in person. And he soon expressed how he loved the music that he heard me play and arrange. He especially loved the music that I have recorded and the arrangements that I have written for a CD called Eliane Elias Plays Jobim, was the music of Antonio Carlos Jobim. And he wondered if I would be interested in doing this work, you know, of arranging and producing and playing on his music. Mitch Lee handed me a CD of the original cast production of Men of La Mancha, and that was my source to listen to the songs and to see what I felt. And I soon started working on the material and chose 9 songs. There were 14 songs recorded on the CD, and I chose 9 songs and I started working on the arrangements. He really gave me a lot of freedom, you know, artistic freedom to do whatever I wanted to do, and he wanted that from me. He very clearly said, I want the Eliane imprint on the arrangements. I created introductions, endings, interludes, different treatments, you know, different ways of treating the songs, like where I always stay close to the melody, preserving the melody and the message of the song, but creating different harmonies, you know, new harmonization and rhythms. I played a lot with the rhythms as well and modulations. For the recording, I called a fantastic group of musicians. It's an all-star recording. The 2 musicians that were part of the Eliane Elias Plays Jobim had to be there, of course. There was Jack DeJohnette on drums and Eddie Gomez on bass. Plus my working trio with Mark Johnson on bass and Satoshi Takeshi on drums. And also Manolo Badrena, who is a fantastic percussionist. So we had, I wrote 5 arrangements to be recorded with Jack and Eddie, and 4 arrangements to be recorded with Mark and Satoshi. And Manolo Badrena played on 8 of them. The album is an all-instrumental album, and we had just about the best of everything. You know, he asked me what was my favorite studio to record in, and I said that I liked Power Station, so we went to Power Station Studios, Studio A, and had a beautiful concert Steinway D that Steinway sent to me, as I always get to choose the instrument I want to record with. And the sound was beautiful, the musicians were beautiful, and the recording came out really great. Mitch was so happy. We ended up mixing at his studio called Secret Sound. He had a studio on 57th Street. Of course, I was attracted to all the songs that I chose to record, but some of them were a little more special than others to me. The first 3 songs, To Each His Dulcinea, and What Does He Want of Me, are a good example of what you're going to be listening on this recording, because it features the 2 different trios, and it starts by featuring, if you know the music from Men of La Mancha, you'll hear the melodies there, but you can also hear the new parts that were incorporated into the arrangements. The first tune has elements of Brazilian music and has also Latin rhythms. The second tune, Dulcinea, is a tune, is a ballad, it's a beautiful ballad, and has some modulations. And I remember when we finished recording that Mitch really loved it. He had tears in his eyes and he says, no need for a second take. We kept that first take. The third tune is a tune that has a loose kind of backbeat. What does he want of me? And it was it demonstrates some interplay between myself, Jack, and Eddie. And it goes on into different rhythms, Brazilian rhythms that were incorporated into other tunes. For example, the Barber song is a baião, and I play that melody. Every note of the melody is harmonized, and it's something that we call over the bar line. It's like you don't really feel the bar line. You know, the melody travels in a very cool way. Another tune that has Brazilian rhythms is a little gossip. It's almost like a Brazilian carnival. It has the rhythm of frevo, a rhythm from the northeast of Brazil, and it came out in a very cool way. Every tune brings something different. We have more straight ahead, like it's all the same. And Mano La Mancha. Mano La Mancha, Jack the Jeanette played a very cool, like a very cool groove. This music is very passionate, and the melodies are catchy. And with the freedom that Mitch gave me to arrange and to harmonize them, you know, I was able to bring certain colors that I look for. I always pay attention to the aspect of the arrangements that bring color, that bring passion, that it can be heard and can be felt. Those are devices that I use with harmony, with rhythms, with modulations, and choices that are made in creating other parts also for the arranging. This music is passionate and is romantic and is exciting. You know, it's got all these different elements, and the combination of the rhythms also, of course, helped in that. I feel that from beginning to end, this album tells a story, and I believe that will take the listener on a journey. And for someone who knows the songs from the show, this great show, Mano La Mancha, they will see, you know, they'll still recognize the songs and hear the arranging. But the ones that don't know the songs, I'm sure that they will relate to them, because they really have beautiful moments, nice melodies to work with, and always passionate. I believe the most well-known song from the show is The Impossible Dream. It's a tune that I knew myself quite well before the recording, and there was a natural choice to choose to include that song on the CD. So I treated the song as a samba, and he loved that, and he wanted exactly like that. And there are lots of modulations on this arrangement, so there's this build-up that happens, and then the climax of the arrangement with towards the end, and then a release where it ends really calm. And it was you know, a moment that he loved. He loved that take, and the way the arrangement came out, and the performance too. Every recording that I prepare, you know, I always have the listener in mind, of course, and I want the listener to enjoy, to travel with that, to take something, you know, from the music. And this was not different. But not only I wanted to please the listener, but what was so joyful to me was to, as an arranger, you know, from the arranger's chair, when you are dealing with a composer and the music of this composer, and you prepare and you see how thrilled the composer is with the work that you did, and when he hears his songs reimagined, I mean, that's the most gratifying moment for me. It was the most gratifying to see how he loved the work that we did, and I really hope everyone feels the same. My last two recordings received Grammys, you know, and I'm so thrilled to say that. When people come to hear my concerts, they will hear a wider spectrum of what I do when I present music. And of course, I'll be playing music from Mano La Mancha, but also some of the things that I have done before, including singing. I'm Eliane Elias, and I'll be touring a lot behind this recording, and I hope you can be in one of the concerts and join us to celebrate the music from Mano La Mancha.